I get so many questions about my Tesla solar roof, and I have to thank you. Most of you are full of praise and seem to really enjoy my video series, where I documented the entire process from ordering, installation, payments, savings, cleaning, you name it. But some of you had some concerns. So in this video, I'm going to address the top 10 questions, counting down from least to most, shall we say, bizarre. And this is happening right now. Starting with number 10, the least bizarre question was about the peak performance of the system. Now I have about 135 active solar tiles facing in various directions towards the sun. Each active tile has a maximum 58.47 watts. And together this comes to just under 7.9 kilowatts. However, the peak performance I've been able to measure is about 5.9 kilowatts. And people were wondering, why is it not 7.9 or close to it? The answer is quite simple. The tiles are not facing the sun at optimum level all at the same time. An east-facing tile might reach peak performance in the morning, while a south-facing tile might get there around noon. And unlike regular panels, some of the tiles will actually face to the north. So they may never produce more than 50% of their rated maximum, simply because the sun will never reach them in an optimal way. The tiles are basically a roof first and a power plant second. All right, moving on to number 9. Since the roof is electrified in its entirety, isn't it a big fire hazard and a risk to firemen? What about smoke ventilation when you need to control the fire? To be honest, I haven't really considered this until you brought it up. But luckily, after a little bit of research, I was able to find out that the roof is quite safe and easy to ventilate in case of smoke. There's a great video by Brock Archer, who posted a training tutorial developed by firefighters and engineers from around the world.
Typically, only about 16 volts is present in each branch. All of the testing conducted indicated that there is almost zero risk of shock or electrocution when cutting or crushing the tiles or when cutting the diode trunk harness.
It demonstrates some simple solutions on how to safely and effectively handle a Tesla solar roof. I'll leave a link in the description. It's quite fun watching them destroy the tiles. Number 8 on our bizarro list. Not quite bizarre yet. Tesla has gotten quite a bad rap when it comes to service. I'm an avid reader of the Tesla Solar Reddit thread, and not a day goes by where someone is complaining about their Tesla project manager, wait times on the install or repairs.
Thank you for calling Tesla. Your estimated hold time is greater than 1 hour.
Clearly, Tesla needs to do better. When I got my Model 3, there was a small blemish on the paint job. So I brought it in for service, and that first appointment was terrible. Tesla was in the midst of ramping their mass production, and they were ill-equipped to deal with the increased need for service. But that changed. All other service calls have been stellar. No wait time. Often I didn't even have to bring in the car. They would come to my house to address a service request. I expect that Tesla Solar is going through a similar transition right now. Maybe I was lucky, but I needed quite a lot of help from the Tesla team to get a grant approved, and my caseworker was responsive and on top of all deadlines. Also, after a storm, one of the ridge covers blew off. Luckily, they have a 24-hour hotline and a crew came out to repair the exposed ridge vent, and they prevented water from coming into my attic. I was very happy with the service. Number 7. Plenty of people commented that the Tesla roof is outrageously expensive. It's a valid point. $50,000 is a lot of money, and I made a separate video just about why it still may make sense to many to make that investment. Let's just say, once you realize that it's not just a solar system, but a full premium roof replacement and a battery that protects you from power outages, $50,000 might seem more reasonable. Unfortunately, Tesla raised their prices, and they will probably remain expensive until they can keep up with the demand. However, I just placed an order on my garage, which I'm still remodeling, and the quote for that smaller roof came in at $19,000, including an additional battery. Since this is new construction, the price does not appear to have gone up all that much, because they don't need to replace the old one. Counting down to number 6. Still not that bizarre yet, but a lot of you think that solar is not environmentally friendly. You have concerns about the toxic materials used to make them, the carbon footprint, and unethical mining of certain metals. I've done some research and I'm going to leave you two different sources. One of them is a big report by the Cambridge University that analyzed all major peer-reviewed studies on the environmental impact of solar. And the bottom line is this. While there are no global warming emissions associated with generating electricity from solar energy, there are emissions associated with other stages of the solar life cycles. Most estimates of life cycle emissions for photovoltaic systems are between 0.07 and 0.18 pounds of carbon dioxide equivalent per kilowatt hour. This is far less than the life cycle emission rates for natural gas and coal. The second source comes from Tesla directly. Every year they publish a comprehensive environmental impact report on their entire product line, supply chain, distribution, manufacturing, and end-of-life recycling programs. If you think that Tesla actually cares about expediting our transition to sustainable energy, which I happen to do, that report can help you understand the steps they take to accomplish that goal. All right, number five, hail. Some think that the Tesla glass cannot withstand a hailstorm, hurricanes, or other extreme weather situations. Well, here's a video that begs to differ.
Pretty significant, consistent ping pong to large golf ball size. The next morning, and we looked around, and I'm like, I don't see anything of significance in terms of damage, you know, to the roof. There's no hairline cracks, there's no functional degradation, you know, performance degradation.
Solar roof tiles are more than three times stronger than your standard roofing tile. It has a hail rating of class 3. It can take a hail clump of this size repeatedly. It also has a class F best wind rating.
This is the ultimate version of that moment. You get the 100-year cold snap, you power up the battery, and you look down the street, and you're like, damn, it actually did matter.
Okay, you might think, so far the questions haven't been all that bizarre. Well, it's time to step it up a notch. Number four. Many of you had concerns when you saw shots of the crew kicking the tiles during the install process. You thought that was unprofessional and damaging the tiles. Well, several sources confirmed that this is actually the best way to install the tiles, and it's the way the crew is being trained to do that. There were many Tesla workers and reps that responded to these comments on my video backing this up. So yes, if you see the crew kicking the tile, totally okay. They can take all kinds of beating. There's no micro fracturing as with regular panels. Now that we cleared that up, let's go to number three. We'll get to the good stuff now. Talking about the good stuff, it's the perfect segue to thank Skillshare for their support. It's an online learning community where millions come together to take the next step in their creative or career journey. It offers thousands of classes on topics including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and more. I'd like to recommend a class by Hayden Obi, where he presents a simple five-step process to teach yourself to draw
just about anything that you'd ever want to draw. This is a routine that you can apply to it so that you actually make sure that you learn.
Within just 25 minutes of practicing, you'll take a reference photo, learn how to break it down into its most simple shapes, emulate those shapes, and go back to fix your mistakes.
It's very important that we don't just notice the problems that we've had, but that we actually correct them.
Finally, you revise and repeat, getting your first drawing to go from zero to pretty awesome in just one session.
To actually put this into practical use, you are going to choose a subject of your own and you're going to go through the five steps.
And this is what's great about Skillshare. It's curated specifically for learning, meaning there are no ads, and they're always launching new premium classes so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. So take advantage now. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare so you can start exploring your creativity today. Now, back to your question about the warp. Some of you commented on a warp in my roof and you are correct. On one side, there's actually a warp which has to do with a roof inconsistency when the original house was connected to an addition. This is something that I haven't really noticed before, but going back to the shots from the original roof, you can clearly see a transition line here. Now, whenever there are inconsistencies, the tiles are not really bendable. Instead, what Tesla does is use actual metal tiles in those spots and bend them into place. The metal is so thick that you can't bend it by hand. Instead, you need special tools. And this is what they used at the transition line. However, some of the metal tiles still are not perfectly aligned and you can see a panel gap. When they come back for my garage remodel, I will definitely ask them to give that side another pass. Number 2. Supposedly collecting rainwater is illegal. So in several videos I point out that a nice side effect of having a clean glass tile, and a metal roof for that matter, is that you can collect rainwater and not have to worry about the petroleum leaching of an asphalt shingle. Now, this blew me away, but several claimed that it is illegal to collect rainwater in California. It's really strange, since many cities in California actually have programs where they give out free rain barrels to encourage rainwater collection. So I went back to Google and figured out that before 2012, it might have been indeed illegal to collect rainwater. Well, not anymore. Most states will let you collect rainwater, no problem. However, if you happen to live in Texas, while still legal, you'll face some of the toughest requirements to collect rainwater, including giving written notice to your city and submitting a full building design plan. And this brings us to numero uno of your most pressing concerns for my Tesla solar roof. And it has to do with my garden. Every day there's one guy who tells me, often in a not so nice way, that I should get a frickin' lawn.
People keep complaining about our front yard.
What's wrong with our front yard?
Well, they always want like lawn. They don't understand what we do.
Hello? Drought mud?
They don't appreciate a Joshua tree.
Yeah, hello? Meet Joshua.
He's gonna be such a beauty.
Yeah, he's awesome.
He's gonna be 15 feet tall.
I don't know, but he's showing his beauty.
We have what is called a California native rain garden. My city actually paid me over $3,500 to convert the lawn we used to have into this wildlife oasis in order to eliminate the need for constant irrigation. Before we had this garden, we used to spend more than $200 a month on watering and an additional fee on a gardener who would have to come out every week to mow and blow. Did you know that if you run a lawnmower for an hour, it creates as much carbon emission as if you drive over 100 miles with your everyday car? So, no, we're not going to get back to a lawn. If you'd like to find out how we set up that garden with the valley and berms to ensure that the little rain we do get in California stays on the property and does not shed into the storm drains, I'll leave a link to a video series where I show you the steps we took. I hope you enjoyed this video. If I missed any other question, especially more bizarre ones, please do leave a comment. I'll try to address them. As always, thanks for watching and keep things sunny. Oh, and if you're thinking about getting a Tesla solar roof or the panels, which supposedly have the best deal on the market, please click my referral code to check out all the current savings. The link, as always, in the video description. We'll be right back.